Hello, world. My name is Ron Williams. I'm a proud parent. I'm with a group here called the Ketones, and we've got a message for the world called the Big Fat Lie. Tiara? There's a lot of curiosity out there about this big fat lie. It's a remarkable time in history when ignorance is anything but bliss. Is it possible that this very ignorance is resulting in the sickest generation ever, the fattest generation ever, and the first generation projected to outlive their children? Our children think they're health nuts when it says 10% juice on their candy. And why is childhood diabetes in the beginning stages of epidemic? What about childhood obesity? Could these be the children of the lie? There are actually obese kids being taken away from ignorant parents with whispers of negligent homicide. As a parent, I'm taking a stand. Before understanding this big fat lie, let's go back in time, thousands of years ago, where in each village the people lived on a primal diet, living off the land. If God made it, eat it. This primal diet was the original fast food. They picked it and they ate it. Folk wisdom is very powerful, even intuitive. Are carrots actually good for the eyes? And how about walnuts in the brain? And why does a tomato look just like a heart? And oh yeah, primal wisdom included walking. Sounds like they had a ton of energy to me. Maybe their kind of ignorance was a blessing, while ours, a curse. This primal diet extends the benefits of ketosis beyond birth. Well, what is ketosis? It's where our energy came from burning fat before the man-made invention of packaged carbs we know today. Now, fast forward from that village to cold concrete, from ketosis to mictosis. The fast food munchable era of foodless foods and lifeless drinks, fruit, loops, and crunch, berries and apple jacks. Suddenly the big fat lie is born. Man-made packaged addictive carbs bearing fat-free or sugar-free on their labels. Now, there are huge carboholics everywhere with addictive compulsive eating patterns, with addictive compulsive spending patterns for their next fix. Could it be that carboholic behavior was created in labs, perfecting the carboholic business model? Bet you can't just eat one? Maybe somebody in some lab somewhere has hedged their bets like a thief in the night, robbing you of your willpower, pocketbook, your health, wellness, even your divine being. Have we become human pawns or test subjects to the big fat lie, with big fat business models that prey upon the ignorance of the emerging shorter, fatter, and dumber population? We cannot create and sustain our dreams if we're stepping over our health to get there. Consider the effects on our self-worth, our love, and our intimacy, inherited by default to our children who are all but blindfolded by their innocence during this execution of this chemical warfare, a slow but spendy death, digging graves with our own knives and forks. This addiction dwarfs any drug. The dealing of preserved and packaged carbs that carry a shelf life that may outlive you, serving only as a preservative for a decomposing body. These packaged carbs convert to sugar and morph into fat. Ask any diabetic. The economics are astounding. These foods top the charts on the glycemic index. They are the big fat lie. Short bursts of energy, the crash, depression for some, looking for that next hit. Then pull out your wallet, fork out even more money, and actually pay for a heavier, lazier slave to this addictive cycle. When I think of it, maybe we're all children of the big fat lie. And it's our ignorance that supports the biggest and most lucrative healthcare system in history. 1 in 4 children in America are on medication. And we're okay with this? Isn't properly prescribed medicine the third leading cause of death, only after heart disease and cancer? Talk about friendly fire or target practice. This kind of practice they call healthcare, but I'll just say it, it's sick care, a booming business dependent on our ignorance. And oh yeah, practice? Interesting word choice. There are many great doctors and health practitioners who understand that health is our responsibility, and that health is a habit, not an event. There used to be doctors on this planet that were only paid when we were healthy. Imagine that. We have to get real by acknowledging the big elephant in the waiting room, the patient. Before any practice, why don't we all play the game of health first? The results of our ignorance weighs in heavier than any body of people in the history of man, literally. From primal to carnal, from the village to concrete, ketosis to mictosis. Ignorance? We'll give each other the benefit of the doubt. The big fat lie preyed upon our ignorance. But as of right now, ignorance is no longer an excuse. For me, for you, for our children, or anyone who hears this message, it's now on us. Let's take this lemon and make lemonade. Let's take this fat and make energy. Let's give our joints and organs a rest. Let's bring back all of our beauty and our self-worth. Everywhere you look, there are credible studies that educate us on ketones and general health, energy, cognitive function, and even more serious health concerns that include inflammation and obesity. And you thought these packaged drug-like carbs gave you energy? Fat produces 225% more energy. Maybe that explains why babies are born in ketosis. Tragically, the children of the lie forget as soon as they see that cartoon character's face on their first hit in this carboholic culture. I am a carboholic. My ignorance weighed in at 40 extra pounds. Who knows the price I've paid for my health by my own ignorance? Even the comfortable fashion that comes from comfortable foods, it was all buns and rolls for me. Hundreds of so-called diets have come and gone. Trendy diets that steal life and energy from your future. The irony of this is that it is estimated that the money Americans spend annually on these trendy diets would feed the world's hungry for roughly 2 years. Your health is not a trend. It is as timeless as the sky is blue. Ketosis can bring us back to the village, allowing us to be decisive eaters and not compulsive eaters. So how come everyone isn't in ketosis? Well, they would if it were that easy. Getting into ketosis is hard in this new carboholic battleground. It takes days of unrealistic perfection and pain. I've tried and failed many times. Wouldn't it be great if there was a scientific breakthrough that converted days of pain into only hours of energy and bliss? Ketosis. Well, there is. Ketonics. Come back to the village. Ketopia is the village. Let's turn ignorance into energy, love, quality, peace, success, beauty, and attraction, all hunger-free. Our bodies will perform miracles by the minute when we honor and edify its miraculous intelligence. All it needs are the proper raw materials. This raw material may be worth its weight in gold to you. You are just one ketonics drink away from your vigorous walk across the bridge to Ketopia. You'll know when you're there. Pay it forward by telling someone today. And welcome to Ketopia. And remember, burn fat or abuse carbs.